कंडीशन फॉर गुड हाइपोथेसिस और साउंड हाइपोथेसिस. फर्स्ट इज रिलेवेंस. द फंक्शन ऑफ हाइपोथेसिस इज टू एक्सप्लेन द फैक्ट्स विच हैव बिकम अ प्रॉब्लम. इट कैन सर्व दिस पर्पज ओनली इफ इट इज रिलेवेंट. वेन इट इज रिलेवेंट हाइपोथेसिस देन द फैक्ट्स कैन बी एक्सप्लेन क्लियरली एंड रिलेवेंटली. सो रिलेवेंस इज अ कंडीशन. सेकेंड इज सेल्फ कंसिस्टेंसी. A hypothesis must not be inconsistent, it must be self-consistent. Then testability. A hypothesis is put forward for explaining the observed fact. A hypothesis is said to be testable, means verifiable, if it is capable of being shown to be either true or false. Fourth, simplicity. Simpler hypothesis is one which makes the minimum number of independent assumptions. So these are the conditions for the good hypothesis or for the sound hypothesis. Write the uses of language and impediments in good reasoning. So first we have to write the meaning of language. We use language in many different ways and for many different purposes. The purpose of logic is to improve our critical thinking. To think critically is to recognize, construct, analyze and evaluate arguments. Now the uses of language: informative, evocative, expressive, evaluative and performative. Informative means it gives information to us. When using language informatively can be judged true or false. Language is used to give and take information. Informative may be true or false, but then also it is giving some information about it. Informative use of language itself has many uses. Included are reports, description, analysis, explanations and arguments. Means when we get a information, then it is not possible or it's not always right that the information is perfectly 100% true or false, but it is giving the information. So the language is also used for the informative use. Second is evocative use. Evocative means questions like command are an evocative use of language. Commands are one large group of evocative expression. The sentence is used to evoke the action. Feelings or emotions as well as actions may be evoked by language. Then the expressive use. Expressive means express. We can express our joy, sadness or a pain privately or publicly. Expressions such as oh, wow, ouch, curse and cheer are typical of the expressive use. The expressive use of a language means to express our emotion, ideas with other. So we are social beings and language is a primary vehicle for our social interaction. So it is frequently used to express and evoke. Next is evaluative. Evaluative means here the language is used evaluatively to express the ethical, aesthetic or functional judgment. Terms like good, bad, right, wrong, beautiful, ugly, efficient and inefficient are the clues to the evaluative use of language. Three major areas: ethical, aesthetic and technical. Ethical means it is about the right and wrong duties and obligation, rights and responsibilities. Aesthetic means it is about the beauty and ugliness, the pleasing and displeasing. Then technical, it is about what is useful and useless, efficient and inefficient, functional and dysfunctional. And our fifth is performative use. A performative means expression is used to accomplish some social act in a constant, to reporting, evaluating, provoking or reacting to it. It is not to report an act which has been performed or which will be performed. It is a performance which is done. So here we have seen the five uses of language: informative, evocative, expressive, evaluative and performative.